We got breaking news here on Fisker. The stock is soaring right now, up 18%. The EV maker announcing final details on its deal with Foxconn to do the final assembly of its cars right here in the United States. Let's get to Phil LeBeau live with the CEO of Fisker. Phil.
Thank you, Melissa. Let's bring in Henrik Fisker, the CEO of Fisker, joining us from California. Henrik, let's be clear. You are finalizing the deal today, but you made it clear back in February that this deal was essentially in the works. You signed a memorandum of understanding with Foxconn. Now that the deal has been inked, are you planning to build these vehicles at the Foxconn plant being built in southeastern Wisconsin?
Hey, Phil, good to see you. Well, of course, this is one of the lead places that we're looking at. The truth is that Fisker, you know, we have received offers from three other states for manufacturing, and we have to do proper due diligence as a public company and spend a couple of months reviewing the best option. And of course, Wisconsin is one of the options that's clear, but we will announce the final site probably in about 2 to 3 months together with Foxconn.
Henrik, I'm sure you're aware of, if you mention the name Foxconn to a lot of people in Wisconsin, they will roll their eyes. There are elected leaders in Wisconsin who sit there and say, wait a second, these guys said they were going to be investing several billion dollars in our state. Now it's going to be less than $1 billion. They're not going to bring as many jobs as they originally announced back in 2017. And there's a fair amount of skepticism that Foxconn will ever follow through with building a plant in southeastern Wisconsin. What do you say to people who have a lot of skepticism about Foxconn right now?
Well, you know, we're an American car company. We just, you know, as you know, went public, have still about $900 million in the bank. And this program has now been going on for a couple of months. We signed a final deal, firm deal today. That's important. And, you know, Foxconn, I believe, is going to become more and more important in the automotive world, specifically because, as you have seen with the chip shortage, one of the part of our deal with them is that we will never be out of chips. And being a small car manufacturer like us, not having to stand in line to get chips is a big thing. I've spent multiple times on Zoom and Teams with the chairman of Foxconn, and I can tell you this deal is real. We are going to be building vehicles here in the U.S. We are far along in development. The exterior design has been signed off. It's going to be incredibly innovative. So this is going to happen.
Henrik, will you co-own the facility where the vehicle will be built, or will this be a Foxconn facility? And obviously, you guys are going to be one of the first clients building vehicles at that facility in conjunction with Foxconn.
So it's not a usual automotive deal. The way we have structured this deal, and as we also mentioned, is that it's kind of a co-investment where we have divided certain things up that each have responsibility for. So for example, Foxconn will own the factory. We will own the tooling. We, of course, brand the vehicle, design the vehicle, market and sell the vehicle. And then we are doing profit sharing on this vehicle. So it is a joint investment. However, Foxconn is owning the factory. They're also taking a lead in the global supply chain. And as you know, a car is becoming more and more a computer, and Foxconn probably have one of the biggest electronic supply chains in the world. And that's how we're going to be able to drive costs down. And remember, Phil, this is not just another electric car. It's a premium electric car under $30,000. So it is a high volume, mass market product that's going to be sold globally.
And I know you said production possibly of 250,000 vehicles. Last question, Henrik. When you announced this memorandum of understanding back in February, your stock was at 19. Coming into today, I think it was down close to $9 a share. It's basically been whacked along with the other EV stocks. There are more than a few cynics out there who look at especially EV SPACs and they say they're a long ways from profitability. Why should I get into them right now? What do you say to those people?
Well, I would say don't put everybody in the same bucket. You know, we have closed three deals in less than a year. You know, the first was going public with the Apollo SPAC. The second was the Magna manufacturing agreement with Magna. And finally, now with Foxconn. So one of the things we're doing different than all the other SPACs is we are really lining up to have a complete product portfolio accelerated within only 2 years. So before 2025, we'll have four vehicles on the road. You can't exist with just one cool car. You know, I've been in this business for a while. I've had some difficulties and some failures. I've learned from them. And I think our investors understand that we're different. Now we're going to get put in with everybody else. And of course, you have seen Also, a lot of movement that has to do with Tesla's maybe sales going down in China. But in the end of the day, I think you'll see a few winners coming out, and I believe Fisker is going to be one of them.
Henrik Fisker, the CEO of Fisker. Thank you, Henrik, for joining us from California on a day, Melissa, when they have finalized the agreement with Foxconn to build a vehicle here in the United States. Exact location remains to be seen. But no doubt you see from the reaction of the stock that investors are looking at this and saying, okay, let's see the next step between Fisker and Foxconn. Melissa? Yep.
Phil, thank you. Phil LeBeau. We see the reaction of the stock in the after-hour session. It's interesting, Henrik Fisker had mentioned the time frame, and it seems like a very fast time frame to get a car out into the public and on the market, Guy. But at the same time, Goldman Sachs points out that by the time the Ocean all-electric SUV hits the market, there will be a dozen other all-electric SUVs specifically out there as competition.
And Goldman downgraded the stock a few weeks ago, I think, to sell from hold, $10 price target. There's a lot to unravel here. First of all, they're supposed to report earnings on Monday, this coming Monday, the 17th. If I had been, you know, one of my questions would have been, wouldn't it have been cleaner just to announce everything at once? That's neither here nor there. With that said, major double bottom around that level that Phil talked about at $9 from the October low. And you just mentioned we were trading 32 at one point. I'm inclined, personally, to wait until see what they have to say at earnings and see how the stock trades. A lot of people negative in this name. It's had a huge run to the downside, held that low, but you have that catalyst on Monday you got to be watching out for.
It's got 26% short interest as well, James, in a space that has just been grim death in the past few months.
Right, and I go back to the point of look at the environment we're in. Fisker has got a very storied, checkered and interesting background story with this turnaround. It's a car that people will like because it's less expensive than other EV plays. It's a car and it's a manufacturer that will be in the race for this EV market. And I think the environment and the timing right now is going to be challenging for them because we've had so much money made in so many areas. I think there's going to be a propensity of selling this stock as opposed to buying it, given the competition and given the fact that this particular car isn't necessarily going to make as much money as some of the other manufacturers.
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.